Hello, everybody, again. Sorry to interrupt your lunch. It's time for our gathering. I am Gabriella Scarlatta Eschrick. I'm the Associate Dean in the College of Arts, Sciences, and Letters here at the University of Michigan, Dearborn. I want to welcome all to the 23rd Meeting of Minds at the University of Michigan, Dearborn. I want to welcome in particular our friends from the University of Michigan, Flint. And Oakland University. I also want to thank all of the faculty for taking the time to work with students in order to present their good work today. I know that it takes time and commitment to help our students to not only do their best, but also encourage them to stand in front of their peers and speak up about what makes them passionate. I want to thank Sue Getter for organizing the Meeting of Minds. I want to thank our counterparts at Oakland. At Oakland University and HIT, Bill Dawson do I have the right number, the name number? Yes. And at Roy Barnes and Andre Lewis at Flint. This year's Meeting of Minds is particularly dedicated to engage scholarship, community work, and the precious ties that our three institutions have with the communities that surround us. Our students and our scholarly endeavors do make a difference in the pursuit of the common good. In light of these commitments, I am very happy to introduce the speaker of the 23rd Meeting of Minds, Mr. Stephen Hernandez, an active alumnus of the University of Michigan, Dearborn, who was recently featured in the Castle's newsletter as he truly embodies engaged scholarship. Mr. Hernandez is deeply concerned about his community and committed to do his personal best. Or, as Voltaire would say, il faut cultiver notre jardin. We all must do our best. And we all must do our part. Stephen Hernandez earned his bachelor's degree from the University of Michigan, Dearborn in 2004, where he double majored in history and anthropology with a connection in Latino issues. He is the development and outreach coordinator for Michigan Consumers for Healthcare, a statewide healthcare advocacy organization. Mr. Hernandez joined Michigan Consumers for Healthcare in July 2011, and he currently leads the organization's grant reporting and fund development efforts with an eye towards best practices and enduring sustainability. He is also honored to be the project director for the Michigan Voices for Better Health Project, which helps people who qualify for both Medicare and Medicaid work with improvements for themselves as the system evolves. Finally, he recruits and manages interns to assist in Michigan Consumers for Healthcare's statewide work. As a nonprofit consultant, Mr. Hernandez also works with staff on how to identify sources of restricted and unrestricted funding and pursue them successfully. He's a former co-executive director of a nonprofit organization and is credited with revamping its service model to include outreach to understand populations. Mr. Hernandez also recently launched his own YouTube channel, Stephen Hernandez Nonprofit Fundamentals, which is a source for information, collaboration, and best practices for the nonprofit community in particular, but also for anyone who wants to improve their organization. Content includes best practices, how to do videos and interviews with nonprofit professionals, all delivered in an engaging and fun style that will leave you energized and empowered, as will, I am sure, his remarks today. Please welcome Mr. Stephen Hernandez. Thank you.
Thank you so much for that excellent introduction. I tend to talk very fast and not very loud, so can everyone hear me okay? Okay, I'm seeing a majority of nods. All right, great. So good afternoon, everyone. Again, I'm so honored to be here. I would not be being a good husband if I did not acknowledge that the reason I'm here today is my lovely wife, who was an alumnus like myself, who can't make it here, but she was the one who actually reconnected me with the university. She had heard a report on NPR about something that the campus was doing. She shared it with me, and that's kind of what set me on the path to get me reconnected with the university. So I wanted to thank my lovely wife, Eftikar, for helping me be here today. So in my brief time today, I wanted to achieve four really basic things. The first is to share a quote that I hope that you will remember that someone shared with me when I was around your age, which is, you will meet the same people on the way up as you do on the way down. And I'm going to reference that throughout my speech today. Fourth, I want to congratulate you on all the excellent work that you have done and you will be doing throughout your careers. Thirdly, I want you to start really thinking about the brand of you. And I recognize how dorky that sounds, but bear with me, and I'm going to try and address that in a little bit. And last, I'm going to try and provide some career and life advice that has been helpful to me throughout my career that I wish I would have heard when I was younger, but no time like the present. So, in many ways, my career truly began at the 2003 Meeting of Minds. I was an undergraduate student, just like you. I had presented some research that I had done. And probably like you, a very excited professor kept pestering me. You should really, this is great. This is something people should hear about this. And they kept pestering me and kept pestering me. And I'm like, okay, fine, I'll do this conference. I don't really know what this is, but fine, I'll do it. And again, like many of you, I worked on with a team of my peers long into the night. You know, I broke commitments. I didn't. There's other things I could have done that I chose not to do. And after one very long night, I remember thinking to myself, "Is this worth it? I mean, like, come on. Like, is this worth my time?" I want to tell you, 12 years after the fact, as a gainfully employed liberal arts major, that this is in fact worth your time. The fact that you made the effort, that you are engaged in this research, that you're telling people about that, is a fantastic thing. I'm going to tell you what you can do with that going forward. So, for all of you presenting here today, do not think of this as the end cap of your undergraduate experience. What I would encourage you to think about this as the beginning of your professional career. Let me say that again. For many people who did this with me, and I remember having this conversation 12 years ago, well, this is a really nice way for me to end my undergraduate career. I would disagree with that. I want to encourage you to take what you've learned, the projects that you're working on, and use that as the catalyst to your future career. So, as someone who now writes job postings and sits on hiring committees, if I could speak to my younger self, who was graduating in 2004, a year after I first did this, there are some things I would really encourage myself to do. First, when you apply to a new position, don't just recite your work history. What was the theme of our talk today, the whole purpose of our conference? Community engagement. Every field imaginable is changing. There really is a strong need for community engagement. And that's, you know, defined in a variety of different ways. But I want you all to really think about your work in a broader sense. For those who are engineering students, try to think beyond that. For those of you who are in CASEL or what have you, or like in the literature field, in the language fields, think beyond the specific field of study that you're in and think more towards the community. So if you've done some amazing work as an undergraduate, work that your peers and professors felt so strongly about that they encourage you to do a presentation, to create a poster, as a potential employer now, I want to hear about that. Don't just bury that at the end of your resume. Make that front and center in any application that I hope that you're starting to think about right now. I had a chance to do a brief glance before today and when I came, and there's a couple of the amazing presentations here that caught my eye, such as the risk and rewards of doing research not done before, strength, style, and technique, a scientific approach to voice production, Inside Out, the prison exchange, policies and police procedures, magnitude and location of max erosion in the S-bend. All these projects may seem very disconnected from one another, but just talking to the students, they had a very strong understanding of what the relevance to their specific field. What I'm here to talk to you about is that there are so many things that you can engage your community in that would be very interested in the work that you're doing. For those who are doing the police procedures work, there is funding right now because of the national conversation around police issues, race relations. There are organizations right now in Flint, in Detroit, that are doing that work, who would love to partner with you. For those who are doing on the work around Max Erosion, I just attended a wonderful conference called Hacking Health, which is really about people from all kinds of different fields coming together to address very specific health issues that are self-generated from the attendees, many of whom are students or young folks just like yourself. So you may not think of your work as beyond engineering, beyond social sciences, but there are many people who would like to hire you who would really think about it that way, who might want to fund your work. I want you to think about that. So please take a moment and look around. You'll see your fellow students and your professors. That's what they have been, but going forward, I want you to think about them as potential colleagues and mentors. Build on the spirit of engagement that you've put together here today, because, as I said before, the people you meet on the way up are the people you will meet on the way down. And what do I mean by that? Right now, the people who are in this room, you may not know them, you may not like them. 5 years from now, 10 years from now, 15 years from now, you may be on the path in your career and you will meet these same people again. The interactions, the partnerships you develop right now will have a tremendous impact in your life going forward. So remember that. Be kind, be respectful, but be engaged. You never know when something like this can start you on the path where you really want to go, which is ultimately what happened to me when I was a Media Minds alumnus. So just a little bit about that. After I graduated from U of M Dearborn, I realized I had a lot of interests, like many of you possibly do, but I didn't have a clear path towards what I wanted to do. I didn't know exactly what I wanted to do. So I contacted U of M Dearborn's internship office after I graduated, and I asked them, how can I get into the political field? That's what I was really interested in at the time. They suggested, well, we have a great internship program that's connected to the state legislature. Would you like to do that? My response was, I wish I would have thought of that 2 years ago when I was a junior, but yes, I would like to do that. I did that, I applied. They asked me, well, we usually take students, you've graduated already, why are you interested in doing this? My hook to them, my unique value to them was, I'm not doing this for academic credit. I'm really engaged in this work. It was very specific to my community. The representative was from where I lived. That was my unique selling point to them. I wound up staying there for a year, working off campus, and that I leveraged that into managing a campaign, and then that became a statewide opportunity. And that really was my first paid out of college, using my degree, big boy kind of job that I parlayed into other work. Okay? Again, it was something because I reached out to the mentors who are here. There are so many people in this room and in your home institutions who really want you to succeed, who want to be your mentors, but you have to reach out to them. They don't know what you want to do unless you tell them. And even if you don't know, that's okay. You can talk to them about your interests. I had conversations with my professors. I think I want to do this. I think I want to do that. How would I go about doing that? So this goes to my other major point, which is building the brand of you. Even if you're young right now, I want you to start thinking about what is it that I want to do? And even if it sounds silly or ridiculous or unattainable right now, start talking about it. Talk to it about your peers, to your mentors. For myself, my career goal is to be a program officer at a foundation. So eventually I hope to be giving money to the university, not just my own, but from my own institution. That is a long-term goal. But I talk to my peers and to my mentors about that. And so this is a very specific piece of advice I want to give to you. Think right now. What do you want to do, right? Figure out who is a leader in the field. Use your social media, not just for, you know, talking about what you ate and your friends and whatnot. Follow the institutions, follow the organizations that are of interest to you. Talk about the projects that you're working on, not just here, but in other things. You will get noticed that way. You're still students. You can still, you know, use that college rate, that student rate to attend conferences, things like Hacking Health. You can engage in national organizations who really desperately want young people to come. Many, many fields recognize they need new blood to come into the field, and they're desperate for people to attend, to show interest in the work. And they will gladly make accommodations for you to come. So you're networking with those people. To take it a bit further, identify one or two or three really key mentors. If you're interested politically, find someone who's running for office. They'll maybe take you on as an intern or maybe, God forbid, a paid staff person. You can learn that way. If there's a professor that you have, ask them, what research is big in the field right now? What materials should I be reading? What conferences should I be attending? These are the questions you will be asking yourself 5 or 10 years down the road when you have a lot of student debt and you're maybe not working where you want to. These are the things that you need to do to get to where you want to go. And again, it's ultimately tied to how you work in the community. That's what employers want to see. No matter what the particular field is, they want to see that you're engaged in your community in some way. So as I wrap up, I want to address a couple of very specific things. And this is some very practical advice that's been given to me that I think will hopefully be helpful to you. If you don't currently have an online presence professionally, such as LinkedIn or YouTube in my case, create one. Create one this weekend. You are very soon running out of time where, like, you know, just having a resume is something that you can kind of do. You really need to start thinking about that right now. Put your Media of Minds experience front and center. That's a very interesting thing. That's a unique hook. That might be that one thing that gets you the call back. That might be that one thing that gets you into the door, which is where many of you are at right now. Explore lesser-known job sites such as idealist.org, M&A Jobs, M&A Online, or your school's job board. Talk to those mentors. Is there an open position in your department? Do you need a TA? Things like that. For the more daring among you, reach out to headhunters or talent search professionals. You can go to job boards such as Koya Leadership Partners. They hire for mid-level to higher-level positions. You may not be ready for those now, but start establishing those relationships with those headhunters now. Because when you start talking to them about 5 to 10 years from now, I want to do this, there may not be that job for you yet, but there may be a job that you're ready for now, or you'll be ready for a year from now, and they will remember you. They will call you back. If you have a LinkedIn profile, people that you don't even know will contact you based on the experience that you've gained here today, the work that you're doing as you end your undergraduate career. Get your name out there. Hustle, 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 whatever your field is. Talk about what you want to do. Be very loud and proud about that. Use today as a catalyst for your next step. You know, you may be an engineering student, and that's all that you want to do. I'm thinking of my friend Adam, but he loves dogs. And so he designs apps for his local chapter of the Humane Society. That's something he really likes to do. He's engaged in his community. And that, because he did that, he was at a dog park and he met someone who was the CEO of a tech company, and they had a conversation about dogs, and they had a conversation about apps, and now he works for a worldwide, you know, software company. Again, always hustle. You never know that connection that you will make, the person that you will meet will change your life. The people that you meet on the way up are the same people as you meet on the way down. So think about that now. Think about who could potentially give back to you. Know your value and lead with it. I'm almost done. Know your value and lead with it. If you're terrible at public speaking or if you're a shy person, but you can design the best possible spreadsheet, you're a fantastic graphic designer, lead with that. Okay, your resume should reflect that. If you can produce fantastic videos, but the idea of an interview terrifies you, have an online resume, have a video resume, know what your strength is and lead with that. Be engaged with your community, because if you yourself are terrible at interviews, people will speak for you. It's like, oh, you know, Bob's awful at that. But really, give him a chance. He can be of great value to you. I know it'll take you time to get where you want to be, but if you take these steps, if you remember why you did what you did today and you capitalize on that, use it for what you want to do. Figure out that path, and even if it's a long walk, taking the first step today and beyond will really help you get there. Thank you so much. Congratulations on your work, and thank you so much for having me here today.